Yes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In video number 1254, I shared how to eliminate short circuit from a capacitor bank. I received comments from my viewers. Let's read that comments and we will see more tricks that are helpful to determine short circuit in a parallel connected capacitor bank. I will install a short circuited capacitor and we will see more possibilities, more tricks to find short circuit. Excellent, mashallah, good job bro. Thank you brother. Gauri Pratap Shankar 9197. Informative video, thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you brother. Can you use non-contact voltage detector to quickly check if power disconnected circuit board has any voltage? I think no. If we don't restore a good capacitor after removing the damaged one, does it have any negative impact? If there is one capacitor damaged, we can compromise. If one capacitor is missing, that will not affect too much because this is closest charge reservoir, charge tank for this processor. It is always high than its actual requirements of the processor. If one capacitor is missing, we can compromise. But it is best to install a capacitor to complete this bank. Then this comment, I have replaced quite a few SMD capacitors but never found a bad one inside the CPU socket. Great video, thanks for sharing. Thanks for sharing. Gracious trick. Thanks Master Haseeb. Thank you. Candle wax could be used successfully. Prepare a candle dissolved in acetone or gasoline or whatsoever. Use a brush. Connect the circuit to low voltage without need of high amperage. The wax will melt first in place of that defect because it heats up first. We also have the modern method. Now we have thermal cameras. This is very beautiful and informative comment. I am thankful from my side and behalf of my viewers for writing this comment. Thermal camera. IR camera, wax plus acetone, benzene, thinner, hand sanitizer. We can also use freeze it. It is Chemtronics freeze it. We will use it now. Please more those tricks. I would be tempted to cut the track. We can also cut the track. That time we will isolate the problematic area, but that will degrade the circuit. Sir, I did not understand how do you find a shorted capacitor. I just noticed that you said you used ground or negative. Yes, you are right. When I was recording video, I said we need to check the data sheet of that specific component where these capacitors are feeding power. If this processor is 3.3 volt, we will not exceed external power supply for 3.3 volt. I demonstrated negative side here, positive side here. Now we will check how to determine negative and positive sides. Okay, the next comment. Can you inject 1 volt in case of fine? Yes, that is the excellent technique. I have 0 to 48 volt power supply adjustable and 0 to 10 ampere. While detecting short circuit, most of the time I use 1 volt and maximum 1.2 volt current to the maximum. We can also use 1.5 volt D size battery cells, or we can use 1.2 volt D size rechargeable cells. That is also an excellent option. You can join 2 or 3 cells together in parallel. That will create 1.2 volt or 1.5 volt with I think 5-6 amperes at a time. Useful. Thank you. Okay, I understand the only 2 lines enter. One line from negative terminal of the polar capacitor and while the second line from the positive terminal of the capacitor. But since the negative terminal of the polar capacitor is short circuited, would not give continuity to the positive terminal. Thank you, excuse me, English is by your translator. No problem. We have any buck regulator, buck converter. In the output stage, there is always a rectifier. It is positive output terminal. Then these voltage are connected to any polar capacitor. If we check MOSFET, in the MOSFET, there is a body diode that is connected in this way. If a switching device is connected here, that will also the same. Any buck regulator, any type of supply converter, that will have approximately the same configuration. So we are taking voltage from here. Here is our capacitor bank. And this is our RL. Now in this bank, if any one line is short circuited, any component is damaged, so its resistance will decrease to extremely minimum level, might be zero, might be few milliohms. That will cause to drop the voltage line here. So no voltage will reach to processor, load will not work. Short circuit in parallel will reflect it as a short circuit in complete line. Very effective, thank you. Excellent, thanks for sharing. Thank you very much. Master, plus, 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 thank you. Thanks for sharing, thank you. Sky Digital Electronics, thank you. And other good tutorial, nice sir. Good work, thanks for sharing. Temperature probe will help us to find faulty components. Temperature probe, current tracer. Current tracer is also very useful. We can also use low temperature melting flux, soldering paste, that is also useful. Informative content, thank you. Would not lower current to reveal short circuit capacitor by using an infrared camera? Yes, we can use infrared camera, we can use thermal camera. What voltage and current you applied? This comment as a reply for my comment, 0 to 48 volt DC, 0 to 10 ampere, it is linear power supply. For workbench, we need linear power supplies. If you have good quality power supplies, that time very rarely these power supplies will damage because those are capable to deliver the current. If you have microvolt meter, HP3456 meter, these are also excellent to determine the short circuit. These will measure in microvolts, 4-wire system. How to determine negative and positive? Also, how to determine correct current to use? Thank you. To find the negative side and positive side, we need to trace the lines from where the power is coming here. When we need to inject voltage here, we must take care for the voltage polarity which we are injecting here. This end is negative, this end is positive, or this is negative, this is positive. These are non-polar capacitors. We need to inject voltage with correct polarity of the circuit. Even it is non-polar, but we need to check the circuit configuration. By connecting reverse polarity power supply, it will clear this short circuit, but it will make more short circuits in the system. Negative supply will enter to this diode. It will become forward bias, it will damage. If it will open, then we will damage this capacitor because polar capacitor will be connected to reverse polarity power supply, so it will damage immediately. These lines are connected together and these are reaching to this side from the bottom side of the board. That is here. So it is reaching to this point. That tracks are reaching to this capacitor, this side. It is FP series Panasonic capacitor. In FP series, aluminium electrolyte capacitors, this bar side is negative. So if this end is connected to capacitor negative side, the second side is positive. This time there is no short circuit. If I will check capacitance, 11 millifarad. Now I will install a short circuited MLCC. I received another comment that when we are injecting high current power supply, that will damage the tracks. I think that will not damage the tracks, because when we are working in capacitor banks, the tracks there are wide tracks that can handle a very huge amount of current, because that are specially designed to handle the current. We can see the track width, it can handle a huge amount of currents. The weakest component is now the plates of this capacitor. Now I will check continuity. That means this time there is a short link. Now I will spray freeze it. And now I will inject power with the same direction. You can see it will heat up very quickly. It is heating up. We will check again. Yes. Now I will spray alcohol. That will heat up and alcohol will vaporize from that point very quickly. If you use wax that is used in candle by thinning it using acetone, benzene or any gasoline product, that will also work same. Now I will use hand sanitizer. Hand sanitizer gel. There are different techniques. Now we can use soldering flux. Soldering paste, low temperature soldering flux. But remember to clean it. If it is small, it will not make a very big sound. But if we are working with polarized capacitors, large capacitors, debris from that capacitor will fly away, that can damage, that can make injury. We need a shield while working on that capacitors. Yes, we detected the short-circuited capacitor. Other capacitors are silent, just only this capacitor is giving smoke. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.